Hey, what's up, everybody? It's DJ Phanatic Beats, content contributor for liveoffbeats.com. If you would like to follow me, you can always follow me at DJ Phanatic on Twitter or Instagram at DJ Phanatic Beats. Phanatic is spelled Phanatic. Basically, I gotta be creative, so. But anyway, I thought I'll show you a video that will help your workflow as a producer. Workflow is so important because, you know, once you want to make a beat, you want to get that idea out of your head as soon as possible and as easy as possible into whatever software you're using. Doesn't matter if you're using this software, FL Studio, or Ableton, or Logic, or Acid, or did I say Logic already? You know, it doesn't matter whatever software you use. Basically, one of the plugins I use to create sounds. It's a virtual instrument. I use Sylenth, and I wanted to teach you how to use Sylenth One, basically how to load in presets and patches, banks. So if you are unfamiliar with Sylenth One, it's a really good program. I'll open it up here for you. It's a good plugin for creating sounds. It's really good for sound design. As you can see, this graphic user interface here, there's tons of different things you can do for every sound, and you can kind of build a lot of sounds from scratch. This is the first one I actually saved. I think it's an arpeggiator. There's a lot in this program, but my main focus was to teach you how to load patches into it. Basically, it has tons of built-in patches. If you go here, presets. Wow, that's just some of them. You can, you know, it's broken down by leads, pads, and you can switch on the fly right here with this. Don't worry about it, I'm not trying to be really musical, I was just... That's me just typing on my keyboard here in front of me. But let me not get sidetracked. I basically wanted to show you real quick how to load sounds into it that are aftermarket. Basically sounds that you buy from, you know, wherever people sell sounds for this particular plugin. And this plugin has so much power that you can create sounds. So people sell sounds that they make. And to load those, you can easily go here. There's two steps. The first step, you can go to menu. And under preset, you can go to load. So what you're going to do, once you click on load, another window pops up and you can navigate to wherever your sounds are. So mine, I made a folder called, in my music folder, I called it My FL Studio Sounds. So this is all my sounds broken down for FL Studio. What I want to do in the future, and I highly recommend, is make another folder just for Sylenth One sounds. You can type it Sylenth One Sounds, Sylenth One Presets, or have two different folders, one with presets and one with banks. But basically, you go here, I forgot where I had it, it's somewhere in here, and I forgot where I had it, actually. Here we go. This is a bank, so this is one. I don't know if there's any silent. Bear with me here. And there's nothing in there for some reason. So anyway, you find a folder and you load it in there. Let me go another route because I don't remember where I put it. So I'll show you something really quick on how to, wasn't planning on it, but this helps you as well. This is like a golden secret right here in FL Studio. You right-click on it and Smart Find. And that entire folder, you can type whatever you want. and search for that particular sound. You want to search for a kick, you want to search for a snare, a vocal, a guitar, whatever, and just type the word in, hit enter, and it'll find wherever that is located. And for some reason, this is highlighted for some. Okay, so that's the first thing it found. And it goes in order. I think it's F3 and F2. You can actually move from that search to the next search it finds. So these, this, whatever this is, Audentity Sylenth Mega Pack. So it shows me how to load banks and patches. So we'll go back to our plugin. And then we'll hit, go to menu, go to preset, go to load. Let me remember where that's at. All right. Go back to wherever your folder is. And I definitely, in the future, I have to make a silent folder because I have so many sounds that I haven't used. So let's find that Audentity. Okay. Sylenth Mega Pack. And here's your banks and patches. And let's just look at the leads here. Okay, we got killer lead one. Let's just get that. And notice it loads into the plugin, and then we can play it. And what's really cool, pardon me. What's really cool is these are all banks here, and it memorizes where it was and loads into the last patch. You notice it has 181, and these are all different banks. So let's say I want to load a bank into bank 1. This is a Sylenth 1 preset called Gemini. Kind of cool, and you can hear the quality of this plugin. You can, you know, I always enjoy how clean it sounds and how powerful it sounds, and you can get very creative with it. Let's load a bank, and I actually never done this before. So you go to menu, preset, load. We're gonna load a bank on bank 1. So let's go. I wish there was a quick way of doing that. I'm sure there is. Go back to that particular folder, open that up, and we're going to go to banks. No matches, no items match your search. So it would have been a nice example, but that is one way of loading aftermarket sounds to Sylenth 1. Let's do some strings. I never listened to these before, so so let's say you like those string sounds and you want to put it in your beat. You can close that and actually just clone it. Boom. And what it did, it actually cloned the same sound I loaded earlier. So you can use this other sound in addition to, you know, the other pattern with these strings. So notice I have two different instances of Sylenth 1, and I can use those two different instruments I loaded from this folder. The other way you can load into Sylenth 1, and this, again, this is loading sounds that are aftermarket that people have made and sold, or, you know, you got it from somebody or whatever. You can load it through this window here. You hit the gear tool up here on the left, and then you go to the VST wrapper settings right here. There we go. And from presets, you can hit load, and then you navigate again like that to wherever. You know, I have mine in the music folder and hit my music, and they're all over the place. I have tons of folders. I really need to organize some of this because, you know, when I'm working on music, I'm just constantly looking for sounds. And a lot of times I'm running all over the place. It's kind of like playing spades when you, like, you don't organize your hand and you're like looking, making sure you don't renege and pull out a spade when, you know, you weren't supposed to or whatever. But you get the idea, because it's good to have your music, all your sounds organized so you can get to them fast. you get to them fast, you're able to create, get that idea out faster. So, yeah, I'm looking for basically what I had before. There we go. There we go. Found it. It was in a random folder, Sylenth, just called Sylenth. So I taught you how to do a quick search. You know, you can just load it from here. These look like the FXP. It looks like they're just presets. So I don't know what to pick. How about Easy Going? It's a nice day. I ought to got my hair down. You know, let's pick Easy Going. Let's see where it loaded, actually. Easy Going. Okay, so it just loads on whatever bank you chose, and it loads on that preset. So when you load it from that window. So again, the second way of doing it, you hit the little gear, and you go to the VST wrapper settings, and then you load it from here. You can load banks and presets here as well. And the other way is menu, preset, load, and you navigate to your sound. And notice when I did that, it actually saved. Yeah, it saved where I loaded last. See, here's the navigation right there. So you get the idea on how to load aftermarket sounds into Sylenth 1. And it's good for sound design. And, you know, it's a very powerful plugin. I love it. And just, you know, that's another way of getting your sounds organized and loading them into this plugin. So it's always good to have your stuff organized. See, I always get sidetracked and I just start making music. But anyway, it's been your boy DJ Phanatic Beats. Hopefully this helped you because I totally forgot that I can do this. I've always been using stock sounds for a while and I have a lot of sounds that I wasn't using. So this is a way, two different ways to load sounds into Sylenth 1 that weren't already built into the program. So, and also I taught you how to fast search, like do a smart search for your sounds. You just pick whatever folder you want and, you know, whatever. And you right click, smart find, type in, you want a kick, there's no kicks in that. You can search any folder, you know, you can just do a smart find and kick. And what it does, it finds the first folder and you got all your kicks. Cool? All right, so that is a powerful tool to find the sounds that you want in your folders, especially for those that have a lot of sounds, and I have a lot, and actually I don't even think I loaded everything in here, but anyway, I'm gonna keep it short. It's DJ Phanatic Beats. Again, if you want to follow me, you can follow me at Twitter at DJ Phanatic or Instagram at DJ Phanatic Beats, and definitely keep making great music. You know, just keep staying focused. And, you know, always be open to learn something you don't know about, especially when you're working in new different softwares and stuff, and just try things out. So again, DJ Phanatic Beats, content contributor for liveoffbeats.com. All right, y'all. Peace.